meetings had dropped in July 1915. The chairman of Prescot's Interdistrict Councils, William Lucas, asked the council to permission to erect, at his own personal cost, a memorial to the men of Prescot who have fallen and those who might yet fall on the present war. The council accepted the offer and agreed with councillors that this was the best site for the memorial, would be the road space for the West Street and Queen's Church Street. And the commission has given some support to Sam Wells, who witnessed. He produced this wonderful statue of a servicemen, representing a soldier of the South Lancashire Regiment, stood atop the last desert forest columns. Just before the unveiling, Cameron Mitchell reports in the Parish magazine the soldier would be facing south towards France, where so many local men now lay, having given their lives for human country. The memorial was unveiled to great fanfare 100 years ago today, on the 9th of September 1916. Due to be unveiled by Lord Derby, but he was detained in London on state business, and so the honour fell to Colonel Webber in South Lancashire Regiment. On the day of the unveiling, two more men of Prescot fell in France, one of them migrating to Great Britain. Three panels of the memorial were left blank with future inscriptionary names. The Cameron Mitchell read out the names of 40 Prescot men, known as was already fallen, but the true figure is almost as well. This memorial became the annual focus for services of commemoration for the 4th of August, which was the anniversary of the outbreak of the war, until after the armistice in 1918, when the nation adopted the 11th of November, the annual date of remembrance. Cameron Mitchell has maintained a list of casualty names throughout the war, and in February 1919, this list of 148 names was presented to Council Lucas, and these names were inscribed on the remaining three panels of the memorial. During the Second World War, a second list was maintained, and on the 10th of November 1946, the names of 73 men who had fallen in that conflict were also inscribed, and the memorial was rededicated.
Monsignor Denny, dignified priest, Our Lady of Macrobus, and St. Joseph, Senator Body, now be here today and attended me to have a bad call this day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Words from the prophet Micah. What does the Lord require of you but to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God? As we gather here in the spirit of reconciliation, we stand together, united in our shared commemoration of all those who were caught up in the battles of 1916, which saw death suffering on an unprecedented scale. Those who were killed in action or by disease, those who returned and whose lives were changed forever, the bereaved, the lost, the families of those whose fate was never known, the wounded, maimed and injured, and those who held in silence unspeakable memories of war. Let us pray that God will heal all memories and speak a word of peace, and bring us his forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, our light and our defense, breathe your gentle spirit over the ways of our world, and soothe the memories of those who remember past conflicts today. Let us never be overcome by darkness, and may Christ's light lead us through moments of disaster and distress on the path toward reconciliation. For you, O God, are our eternal guide and refuge. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and talk, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Here ends the lesson.
The act of remembrance. Eternal God, our refuge and strength, remember before you all of which spirits and battles of 1916, especially the one who was suffering, those who painted temple waste and devastation, who fought against the odds, during the thinning time, the spoil, the trenches. We call with thanksgiving the loyalty shown to comrades and the bravery.
See the exhibition, and the churchyard is open as well. So thank you very much.